From a state Supreme Court justice to a felon. That is the likely outcome of Diane Hathaway's plea deal tomorrow in federal court.
As 7 Action News investigator Ross Jones broke that story that led to an FBI investigation into bank fraud against Hathaway. What's next now?
Well, Stephen, Carolyn, good evening. Legal experts tell us that Hathaway will likely enter a plea deal that could include prison time, giving up her law license, and her second job as a real estate broker.
Diane Hathaway is used to accepting plea deals. Tomorrow, she'll be offering one of her own. The 20-year judge who served on Michigan's highest court is expected to plead guilty to bank fraud before Judge Corbett O'Meara, marking the end of a 9-month saga that cost her gavel and reputation.
Justice Hathaway threw away her career for $600,000. In fact, she didn't even get the $600,000. She just got out of a mortgage. Why would anyone rationally make that decision?
The plea follows a month-long probe by the FBI, sparked by a 7 Action News investigation into Hathaway's suspicious property shuffle. She moved homes out of her name and into her stepchildren's around the same time she was asking her bank for a short sale, saving her from $600,000 in mortgage debt.
If you look at the cost she's going to pay, it's far more than $600,000.
Hathaway is already at risk of losing her law license, but it may not end there. She's also a licensed real estate broker, and today 7 Action News spoke with a bureau that regulates broker licenses. A spokesperson says it's too early to comment, but if Hathaway were convicted of a felony, the bureau would launch an investigation into her broker's license. She would be evaluated for good moral character. If Hathaway pleads guilty tomorrow as expected, she likely won't be sentenced for several months. And if you think a fellow judge might go easy on her, former prosecutor Peter Henning says not so fast.
The judge may well look at it and say, I'm not going to deviate. I don't want to send the message that judges can play fast and loose with the rules, especially rules of which they are quite well aware.
Now, Hathaway has remained silent throughout this 9-month ordeal, and that's likely to remain the case tomorrow. Her lawyer, Steve Fishman, says she won't be making any public comments outside court, but he will take some of our questions, and we will certainly have a few. Of course, we will bring you the very latest on what happens tomorrow in court, beginning on 7 Action News at noon and at WXYZ.com.